harnessing the inertia of transverse motion of the wheel, that is the up-down motion, to move this platform like this. Oscillate the magnet inside the coil. Our project is based on Faraday's law, which states that
the induced EMF delta across the terminal of the coil is directly proportional to rate of change of flux attached to it.
We demonstrate Faraday's law first, then we... This is a galvanometer, a device that detects current in the circuit. My friend will attach it to the circuit first. Please note the deflection in the needle. When I move the magnet relative to the coil, there is a deflection in the needle which shows that some current is induced in the coil. The faster I move it, the greater the deflection is, and the slower I move, the lesser the deflection. And when I stop moving, the deflection stops. That means that there is no current in the coil. So we thought of using Faraday's law and this current induced to charge a capacitor. But the problem that we were facing is, when the magnet moves from left to right like this, a single capacitor would get charged, but when it goes back, it would get discharged due to the reverse current. What we thought of was using PN junction diodes as valves. Have you seen valves in a bicycle tire that allow the flow of air into the tube but did not allow the air to come out? So now these semiconductor diodes act as valves. They allow the flow of current from P to N direction only. When the magnet moves from right to left here, current is anti-clockwise. It goes in this direction, it gets divided here, but this is N to P, it won't conduct, so there is no current here, but this is from P to N, this is forward bias, it will conduct and the capacitor will get charged. When the wave tilts the platform and the magnet moves back, current becomes clockwise, that is in the reverse direction, and it gets split into two branches again. This is NP, so it won't conduct, and this is PN, so this capacitor will get charged. So this way we are harnessing both the energy of both the to and fro motions of the wave. The to and fro motion. Now this is a 1.5 volt battery that we put in the market. This gives you potential difference 1.43 only. We'll produce a greater voltage across the capacitor in just 5 seconds by reenacting the wave motion. Here it goes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now my friend will measure the potential difference. It comes out to be approximately 1 volt. And this comes out to be 1.29. So total potential difference is 2.13, which is greater than what you get in this cell. And ma'am, you just see that what the power of 2500 copper turns and a simple magnet, what these two can do. When this simple unit can produce this much amount of voltage in 5 seconds, then just imagine what 10,000 such units attached together and left at sea for about a week would be able to produce. The energy that they'll produce will be enormous. Will be enormous, and my friend will give you the statistics.
Ma'am, we have 10,000 such platforms in the sea for about 1 week. The total energy generated, that will be enough to light up about 1,25,000 CFL bulbs of 20 watts each for 24 hours continuously. And if we place 4 CFLs in one room, then the total number of houses that will be able to light up about 31,000 houses. Now, one more thing is that if the total energy that we generated, it will be about burning 22,000 tons of coal. And this is our time to be daily for sustainable development. And in this time, not be a very wise decision. So it saves the 22,000 kgs of coal and it is sustainable. Now if you are going to buy that coal, it's 5 lakhs. So it is economical to it. Is you are getting energy, cheap energy. Now you are actually going to burn 22,000 kgs of coal, but the carbon dioxide produced will be about 78,000 kgs, which is about 50 million liters. It also brings down the carbon dioxide emissions. So if you are getting that, it is energy efficient, it is sustainable, it is economical, cheap, and it is eco-friendly also.
And it does not require any kind of organized motion that is required in turbines. In turbines, you need to control the direction of rotation and also the rate of rotation to produce desirable energy, produce energy that you can use. But here, any amount of disorganized motion will definitely move the magnet inside the coil and definitely produce or store charge in the capacitor.
Would you think that you want to store this kind of power in batteries?
Ma'am, the grid, this whole apparatus would be left in the ocean, in the high seas. So there is no question of any transmission lines going there or any kind of grid. We have to use the storage option. Like we have to discharge the capacitor across storage batteries, and then you can use those batteries in your cars, or you can use those batteries as inverters to convert DC to AC and use it in your cars.
Batteries are a viable option for large
currents. Ma'am, both, in this context, one, the answer, ma'am, the answer is that capacitors have their own advantages and disadvantages. The battery has its own. The capacitor gets easily charged, it's very cheap. These two costs is only 5 rupees. It's light, so it does not, it is not a burden on the platform. It is very cheap and stores a large amount of, larger amount of charge, while a battery stores charge very slowly. Like a battery resistance, 5 tons per kilogram, stores charge slowly. And the other thing is that suppose the wave motion stops, although we are not expecting that, but suppose the wave motion stops, the battery will get start discharging through the wire, start sending current in the opposite direction through the wire, so we don't want that. Storing power from this platform.
Yes, either from this platform or sure.
We have to.
Want to use a battery mechanism, or do you want to use some other mechanism which will directly convert it and feed it to the grid?
What we have thought of is a battery mechanism, as you suggested. We are like want a controller or a ship to pull up batteries to go to the particular site where this thing is anchored. One end of it will be anchored and the rest 10,000 will follow. The maximum displacement that can occur is in a circle. So it will stay at one place, that's good for us. Then the ship will just discharge these capacitors through all the batteries, and you will get a storehouse of energy which can be put ashore. There will be cost in this transportation, and when you discharge the capacitor across the batteries, there will be some energy loss, which will bring down the statistics a bit, but it will be only a bit, and the kind of advantage that you get is not comparable to it. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.